some small fuzzing tips, you could say, which I would like to give people that have helped me recently to get some bounties.
Hey everybody, welcome to this new video, and today we have with ourselves Rogue SMG. Hey buddy, what's going on?
Hey man, all good, apart from this corona. I hope everyone is safe and well. I hope you are safe and well as well.
Same
thank
here.
You for having me here.
Yeah, same here bro, stay safe, stay home.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so what are we going to learn today?
Today there'll be no groundbreaking things we'll be seeing today, but there are just some small fuzzing tips, you could say, which I would like to give people that have helped me recently to get some bounties, and I hope it helps someone.
Sure man, let's begin.
Okay, just a second, let me share my screen. So let me know once you can see my screen.
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay, so let's just see. Just ignore this for now. Mm-hmm. Let's say our target is, we have a target that is target.com. Now what generally you'll do related to URLs is you get URLs from, let's say, Gao or Wayback or maybe Burp history or crawler such as GoSpider, etc. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And then what people generally will do is they either extract the paths or parameters or they essentially just use these URLs for automation in some way or the other. They might use it for maybe XSS or SSRF or even SQLi. So probably it goes something like Gao target, and then if it's XSS, then they'll use probably QS replace, then maybe pipe it to KXSS, and then finally you go to Delphox or something similar, right?
Mm-hmm.
But this way you might get some results, but as you know, a lot of people are knowing these things, and this is probably one of the most common things which anyone will perform on the target. So even if there are chances of success, they are not quite great. You have a very good chance of being duped or so. But what people miss while fuzzing is, and another way is, if let's talk about normal fuzzing. What people will fuzz if it's target.com, then people might fuzz here, right? Here people might fuzz, or some people might go two steps further, and let's say if they find ABC, then they'll recursively fuzz after ABC or XYZ as well. This is also not that common to see. People will generally fuzz on the root path itself and not after the root path, but this is you'll find very interesting stuff this way as well. So don't just fuzz on the root path. If you find something after the root path, like the base path, then try to fuzz after that particular directory or that particular path as well, because a lot of people won't be going that extra mile, and that might give you some juicy information which you can use. So these are the two basic things which everyone might be doing, right? But recently, and I've seen this becoming quite common, and this is nothing great. A lot of people might actually be doing this as well, but I've not seen that many people try to talk about or use this technique. So it goes essentially like, for example, in target.com, let's say there are two roles. One is a normal user and one is an admin user. And for a normal user, let's say there is a URL or a path which is this, and test ABC is let's say just any directory or any implementation of functionality. So this is the path for a normal user, and for admin user, let's say it's a different thing. Like, for example, you might have seen the normal user have a different interface, and the admin user might have let's say a dashboard or something like that. But generally, if you try to, and this goes like this, and generally, if you try to, you know, access this from the normal user, like using normal users' cookies or authentication headers, generally you will get a 403, right? Mm-hmm. And you might try some bypasses as well using the scripts or, you know, using some characters like %2e or so. There are quite some tools out there for, you know, bypassing the 403, so you can try that as well. But even if the target is like fairly protected, then generally you will not be able to find anything apart from a 403, right? But and people I guess will leave it alone from here and just move on and try to find other stuff. But what you can essentially do is, let's say this is giving 403, right? But what you can do is, you can just try this. This, I guess, yeah, we have it here. And this might be the issue. So what we did here is we just selected this path for the normal user. So we have access to the normal user's path, right? And after that, we still are using the same until API, and after that we are just appending /admin/groups after the API call of the normal user, right? After the path of a normal user. And what might happen is you might get a 200 okay, or you might be able to actually view the groups or the admin groups, whatever information is there, right? And why this happens? Because sometimes what might happen is if you try to directly access any paths from, like, normally as we tried here, it gives us a 403. If we try to access the normal path from a normal user, and the path is that of an admin user, it might give you a 403, right? But the path essentially is for the normal user itself, the low privilege user itself, right? And if there is any misconfigurations or the routes are not correctly specified internally, you might be able to find access that information, the admin information, from this path as well. So essentially what I'm trying to say here is, if you have, let's say, target.com, and if you have any subdomain related to that, let's say sub.target.com, then what the current scenario is, you'll try to find paths for target.com, paths for target.com, and then you will try to find paths for sub.target.com, and then you will try to essentially brute force all those paths on each of those respectively. But what you can try to do is, if you can try to find the paths from all of the subdomains of target.com. So what I'm trying to say here is target.com. You fetch all the subs of target.com, and from all the subs, you could fetch all the paths. And by fetching the paths, I mean just subs, then maybe Gao or Wayback or whatever it is, whatever you want. And then use something like unfurl to get the paths, all the paths. And then you will maybe get paths like /dashboard/admin/profile, or maybe something like API v1 and shop or something like that. So what you can try to do is, of course, try to directly brute force all the paths on all the subdomains. If this is a path for target.com, try to brute force that path on sub.target.com as well. Because what might happen is, any path which might not be interesting for target.com might end up being interesting for sub.target.com. So it might help you leak, it might have issues like info disclosure. You might get some info disclosures that way. You might get some IDOS that way. You might also get privilege escalation, as we just saw in the previous example here. Mm-hmm. Here we had privilege escalation, and and some BSE issues, like essentially broken access issues and information disclosure, is what you might be able to find using this way, right? But another step, one more step you can go further is you can have permutations of all the paths. So if there is a path, let's say if this is the path slash dashboard, but there is no path like admin dashboard, then you can have this in your word list. And you can have, similarly, you can have slash API slash V1 slash dashboard as well. So essentially you might be, you might have all the permutations and combinations, different combinations of all the paths you found. And then you could try to brute force using that word list as well. And because of this, you might find a lot of juicy information like privilege escalations and all those kind of stuff, right? Because there are very few people which might have gone this far for trying to fuzz on the target, and the chances of being duped are also very low, and chances of finding something juicy are obviously high. So yeah, this was a small something that I wanted to share with you guys, and I hope you find some bugs using this way.
So one common question that may arise here is like, extracting paths from the result, yes, we get from different sources like Gav and Wayback and GoSpider and Burp and all this. We can use Unfurl, right? That TomNumNum's tool.
Yes, yes. Yes, Unfurl is a tool by TomNumNum. I have mentioned this because I only know this tool, but there might be some different tools as well which might help you, you know, get those paths or stuff. You can even use normal grep itself, but yeah, this makes it very easy for us to, you know, play with the URLs. So okay, yeah, it's a very good tool.
Okay, so for extracting paths we can use Unfurl. So what can we do you know any tools which can help us to like permutate this path?
Yeah, sure. So I guess WW Wordlist, if I'm not wrong, this is the name. This is a tool, I don't remember by whom it is, but I guess this tool helps you to create different permutation combinations of the word list that we have found. And this is also something which I have come across. I hope I'm not wrong about this tool, but yeah, I'll have to check. And I guess there are also many tools. This is something not that trivial, right? And because of that, there are quite a number of tools which will help you to do this thing, as even if that is not the only function of the tool, if you get my point.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, this is a tool, I guess, and maybe Qule would have something similar as well. I'm not quite sure, but yeah, no worries. If I find something, I'll let you know, and we can give this tool in the link for the tool in the description. So that won't be an issue.
Sure. So thank you, Rook, for sharing this amazing tip. So before we close the recording, do you want to share anything with the audience?
Yeah, sure. So as we talked here about recon, right, essentially improving our recon. But if you are a beginner and if you are starting out, I want to say that don't spend too much time on recon, right? Even I personally have made quite a few videos on recon, but and I do quite a bit of recon as well. I don't do anything crazy, and especially recently I'm focusing more on diving deep into the application instead of spending more time on recon. But if you are just beginning out, recon is like the biggest rabbit hole. That this thing is never ending. Like, if there will be new techniques emerging out every day, and there will be something new which you have not tried or which you have not heard of in recon every day. So if you are just starting out and if you spend so much time into recon, or if you just keep trying to improve that recon workflow, I guess you will, by the time you reach the point where you actually have to hunt and actually have to hack on an application, you will already be maybe burnt out or just too busy with finding stuff using recon itself. So And don't get me wrong, recon is like amazing. Many of the great people I know, they just live off recon. They do not even need to touch the main application. They probably earn quite a lot and they know quite a lot of recon. But mostly all those people have been in this game for quite a while now, and that is why I guess they have, you know, they know what they are doing and they know what they need to change and improve. So as a beginner, my biggest tip would be to focus more time on diving deep into the application and, you know, going technical instead of just trying to find information disclosures and stuff like that.
Okay. Thank you, Rogue, for coming once again. So, guys, you can check out Rogue's channel. He also has a YouTube channel. Definitely check it out. He is making some amazing content. So, I will share the link in the description and you can check it out. So, thank you, Rogue. Bye-bye.
Thanks for having me. Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. Yeah. Bye-bye. Okay. Have a great day.
Thanks for watching. You can check out my previous video with Ramon Seth. Also, many more similar videos is in the lineup. So, stay tuned and like, share, and don't forget to subscribe. Peace!